Have you ever imagined driving a car where the steering wheel isn't physically connected to the wheels? That's exactly what Mercedes-Benz is making possible with steer-by-wire, a new technology set to arrive in production models by 2026. Instead of a traditional mechanical link between the steering wheel and the front wheels, this system sends your input electronically through wires. It's fast, precise, and completely transforms the way a car feels on the road. On the highway, it delivers confident, stable handling. In city traffic, it's incredibly agile. And when parking, you don't even need to shift your hands around the wheel. Small movements go a long way. One of the most exciting benefits is interior flexibility. Without a bulky steering column, Mercedes can design a flatter steering wheel, which opens up more space in the cabin, improves visibility, and makes getting in and out of the car easier. But it's not just about comfort. The system also adapts to how you drive. Whether you prefer a sporty, responsive feel, or something smoother and more relaxed, steer-by-wire can adjust to your preferences. It even helps eliminate road vibrations, creating a calmer, more refined experience behind the wheel. And there's more to come. In the future, when cars are parked or driving autonomously, steer-by-wire could enable new in-car features like interactive gaming using the steering wheel itself. Safety is a top priority. Mercedes-Benz has tested this system over 1 million kilometers in both controlled environments and real-world conditions. The technology includes fully redundant components, backup power, dual actuators, and high-precision sensors, so that steering remains functional even if one part fails. In short, steer-by-wire is more than just a new steering system. It's a bold step into the future of mobility, combining innovation, safety, and a new kind of driving freedom. So, would you feel confident driving a car with no mechanical connection to the wheels? Let us know what you think in the comments.
World Cars.